Good afternoon, everyone. Am I visible and audible to all of you? Am I visible and audible to all of you? Get to the chat box and let me know if I am visible and audible to all of you. Yes, okay. All right, so welcome to the demo session for content writing from Henry Harvin Education. My name is Vandana and I will take you through this 1 hour course, and I will ensure that I help you with writing skills as much as I can in 1 hour, right? So there is a chat, please pay attention to the chat box because you will be engaging a lot in this course, in this 1 hour class. So you will have to interact, we have to participate to learn, because participation is required for any kind of learning. Now coming on to the chat box, pay attention to the chat box. There is a message from Henry Harvin, please mark your attendance. There is a link, please click the link and mark your attendance for today's class. Am I audible to all of you? Just say yes, everyone in the chat box, get to the chat boxes. Say yes. Everyone can access the chat box? Okay, let me get to the meeting now. So I see somewhere around 20 participants. Yes, yeah, finally. Is it for 1 o'clock session? For the 1 o'clock session, this is for 1 hour. This is a 1 hour session that we are, I'm gonna take. Yes. So get to the chat boxes. Am I audible and visible to all of you? Are you able to hear me? I hope I am able to. Yes, so, all right, great. So all of you, please make use of the chat box. You're free to ask as many questions as you want to, but you have to make the use of the chat box because you will not be able to unmute yourself, right? Now coming on to the, let's just get to know each other, because the course, I will start with the class at 1 p.m. sharp. But before that, let's just get to know each other. Just post your introduction. What do you do and what brings you to this class into the chat box, so that I understand the requisite of that, what you want to learn here in this class today. So get to the chat box, please. So meanwhile, I will also introduce myself, but then yes, you can please get to the chat box and write in 2 to 5 sentences that what do you do and what brings you to this content writing class today? What do you want to learn in this content writing class? Let's just understand. Waiting for your responses. And if you have any, okay, educator by profession, so if you have any questions about content writing, that this is what I want to learn, you can also post them. I will keep it in mind while teaching. People who are watching us live on YouTube, they can post in the chat box. So, ma'am, I want to learn content writing course. Fine, you are here to learn content writing course, but then what you want to learn in content writing, somebody said. Okay, fine. So Payal is saying that Pavitra is an educator by profession. And okay, so Pavitra, what do you want to learn in this content writing course today? And Payal is saying, I am a CA by profession. I had attended your previous session too. I am here to learn more about the basics of content writing from you. All right, so why don't you join the course from Henry Harvin? You'll get the detailed things, right? Inclined towards writing, and through this session, I want to enhance my write-up. Okay, fine. Megha says that I have already done 3 courses at Henry Harvin just to brush up. I joined this class. I'm a content writer by profession. Well, okay, great. So you will also add some insights. Okay. Rashmi, I am an interior designer. I am yet to start my own company. I'm here to learn content writing. So to start your company, you need to learn content writing. I understand. Okay. What about rest others? So we have somewhere around 24 participants, or let's say 23, excluding me. And Henry, I mean, we'll be 22 participants. I've already bought the content writing course. We'll join the batch soon. Okay, all right, Payal. Fine. Who else? So we have other people as well. In the next 5 minutes, we will get to know each other and we will understand your requisite before we deliver, before I deliver actually, right? I'm Harshad Mehta, I'm retired. I work as realtor. So Mr. Mehta, welcome here. But what do you want to learn in content writing? Okay, Mani Kumar, PhD student, I want to enhance vocabulary and fluent English to write a research article and books. Okay, great. So research writing is going to help you. Okay, articles and books. So it is not only the vocabulary, Mani, it is more about the language skills, the presentation, the tone that you use in your writing. All of that is important when it comes to writing. Kamlesh says, I want to set up my own blog. Okay, great. All the best. I will help you with that. All right. Coming on to other participants as well, I would request you to please post your introduction in 3 to 2 to 5 sentences, what you do and what brings you to this content writing class today, what you want to learn today. So Mr. Mehta is saying, I can write, but learning skills would help me. All right. Also, there is a link in the chat box. Please mark your attendance. Please ensure that you mark your attendance. All right. As I'm not an orator reader, I struggle with the quality writing style and vocabulary. How do we overcome with Henry Harvin courses? Okay, that you will understand after 1 hour, that how do you overcome that? All right. Coming on to the other participants, do share about yourself and also let me know what you want to learn today. So nobody has even suggested that, you know, what I want to learn today in content writing. Content writing is huge. It has 32 content forms and even beyond. There is academic content writing. There is creative writing. There is copywriting. There are many things in content writing. All right. Repasting the link here for here, the attendance. There is a link here in the attendance. In the chat box, please. Click the link and mark your attendance. I am posting it to everyone again. So it is there. So please do that. Please mark your attendance. All right. Deepika, Pranita, there are a lot of people. Anushka, Kanika. All right. And I would prefer to write in my mother tongue rather than in English. Mr. Mehta, the writing rules remain the same, regardless of the language. Okay, so the writing rules do not change. The content writing goes by the rule. However, creative writing, there is a difference. Yeah, so there is a difference between the content writing and creative writing, let me tell you. So writing goes by the rule. The rules don't change regardless of the language. You write in English or you write in Hindi or you write in Marathi or Urdu, the writing rules will remain the same. That will not change. All right. Now coming on to other people as well, if you can please post your introduction, we will start. 2 minutes to go. I can take a few more introduction and then I will start with the course dot at 1 p.m. So meanwhile, I'll just start to share the screen and we can just understand a quick introduction about Henry Harvin. But if I can read some more introductions and understand that what exactly you want to learn here. So we have somewhere around 30 participants. People who are there on YouTube, you can post on the chat box. Okay. Right. So Shah Faisal wants to learn article writing in content writing. Okay, great. So you know what you exactly want to learn. All right. What else? Neha, facing punctuation issues a lot in my writing, so join the class. Okay, we will help you with that. I love to write poems. Shairi, okay, Shairi is anyway poetry and want to become a script writer. Author, is the course helpful for me? Indeed, it is, right? How to avoid grammatical errors. None of us are grammar Nazi, so we can definitely avoid. So how to make the writing impressive by adding power to simple sentences. Right. So I will tell you how to add power to simple sentences and then how you can make the writing impressive. So we'll just start. I'll just quickly start with a quick introduction about Henry Harvin and the content writing course that we have here. The actual course is of 32 hours of live training sessions and obviously two bootcamp sessions or brush up sessions that you call monthly, and 1 year membership of Henry Harvin Content Academy. So there will be engaging assignments, projects. So Henry Harvin has its presence in India, Sri Lanka, San Francisco, and Beijing. All right, they are partners to 60 plus colleges across India, and they are vendor with 150 plus corporates. So as of now, the instructor-led trainings has been delivered to at least 30,000 plus learners and self-paced trainings to 2 lakh learners, right? We are providing 80 plus courses here. The next thing is we explore too much of diverse perspectives of writing, right? So definitely we are going to help you develop a creative thinking and how to develop your content, which is impressive. So we are going to help you with that in the, so the roles that are offered after content writing is you can be a published author, you can be a famous blogger. So when it comes to famous blogger, you can go to Google and type Vandana Saxena blogger to know more about me. I'll share about myself as well. You can work in PR industry, you can work in media, you can work in IT, you can work in digital marketing. You can be a creative writer and you can also work in e-commerce company. So when it comes to digital, right? So what do you do when you have to find something? You Google something, right? So what do? You Google something. Get to the chat boxes, everyone, please. So you Google something and what you get in result, is it not the content? What do you get in result? Get to the chat boxes, please, everyone. Let me just get to the chat box. Information. All right. Please share the curriculum. I mostly write emails to C-level. I need to improve my skills. Okay, fine. So the details or basics. No, what you get is content. So internet or the digital world is ruled by content only. So what do you get? What do you marketing? Somebody who's from a digital marketing background here in this class. Anybody who's from digital marketing background. So what do you market in digital marketing? What do you actually try to market? Do you market anything else other than the content? Obviously. So the digital world or the world today is ruled by content. You find a newspaper, there is content. You are reading an advertisement, there is content. Content is the king, actually. So if even if you own a business, you need some content for your website. You need content for your social media promotion. You need content for business proposal. Everything in this world is ruled by content. You can only market content in the digital world. So content writing is something that will never go out of practice. It is not an off-shelf product that will get redundant. So learning content will help you sail through with the fast changing pace of the digital world, right? So that is why we are here to help you. Henry Harvin is here to help you with. So you can become a digital influencer. You can become a digital content writer. Every industry is open to you once you have become or once you have learned the content writing. In any niche you are working in, content will help you become, it will be an added skill, obviously, and it will help you sail through the digital world. You can become, obviously, a copywriter as well, right? So in this program, once you complete the program, not in this one, but then once you get a complete program, you will learn the requisites of content writing, apply the successful content writing techniques and the concepts. You can assess your own strengths as a writer, because writing is not an off-shelf product. You cannot buy it and, you know, use it. No, writing comes from practice. So it takes years for practice. So to become a writer, right? But then yes, there are a few writing techniques that you should learn as a writer before you start practicing as a writer, right? So there is a plethora of digital platforms and channels that you will get access to, and you perhaps don't even know that there are so many tools for content writing. So we are going to share all of them here, right? And writing or share your writing or publish your work is something that, you know, I have come across many people. How many of you have written something but never tried to publish it? Let's just get to the chat box again. I'll explain that, Kamlesh, right? So how many of you have written something and never published it? Yeah, because you're not confident if it is right or wrong. So let me just tell you, yes, I often write but never publish it. Right, me, all right. So, but let me just tell you that writing is never right or wrong. Writing can only be good or bad. So we are here to tell you about what is good writing skills, right? So I'll give a quick introduction for myself. My name is Vandana, and I'm by discipline, I'm an HR professional, trainer, soft skills trainer, and a content writer. I've been working with Henry Harvin for more than 1 year as a trainer. I have successfully delivered at least 20 to 25 batches for content writing and creative writing trainings. All right, to know more about me, you can go to Google and write Vandana Saxena Writer. I'll be up there. Okay, fine. So shall we start with the course? Say yes in the chat box, everyone. We'll start with the course. We'll start with the course. Yes. All right. So sharing the screen again. If you have any questions, you can keep posting it in the chat box. So let's just say, what is content? After this, I will also, you know, along with this, I will also create a Word file for you so that you are able to understand. So get to the chat boxes. What is content? Let's just see. What do you feel? So first thing, that what is the pronunciation of this word? I'll just... Is the content visible to all of you? Is the content visible to all of you? Yes, get to the chat box. So what is content? First and foremost, let me just tell you how to pronounce this word. This is called content. It is not called content. Content is wrong. As a writer, you should ensure that you pronounce the right language so that you write the right language. Okay, because if you pronounce it wrong, you will eventually write it wrong. This is not called content. This is called content. So we are here to learn content writing. Content has come from contentment, right? This has come from contentment. This means satisfaction. So when you tell the world that I am a content writer, it means you are telling the world that you are a happy writer or you are a satisfied writer. You are not a content writer. So we are here to learn content writing. So write the correct pronunciation of the products for the words. You know, learn the correct pronunciation of the words so that you write them right. Now, the next thing is, what is content? You are scrolling a social media post. Supposedly you are scrolling your Facebook. Everybody is on phone these days. You know, half of the time, half of our life will be spent on phones, I guess. So when you are on your phone, what are you, when you are scrolling something or you are reading something, right? So what is content? What are you reading? Get to the chat boxes fast. Let me just see if there are any answers. What is content? Monica has raised hand. Monica, you can get to the chat box. If you have any questions, you can also write it in the chat box. So let me just say, people who are watching us live on YouTube, yeah, you can... Yes, you people who are watching us live on YouTube, you can post your answers in the chat box as well. I don't see any responses in the chat box. What is content? Anybody knows? No idea? Just give some vague answers, whatever you feel. So see, this is going to be an interactive course. All of you have to participate, right? Unless you participate, let's do some kind of brainstorming. So somebody is saying that content is information. All right, absolutely right. Content is any information that you share. All right, what else? Get to the chat box fast. It's any information. I'm just reading the chat box. Knowledge, okay. Information is meant for knowledge. Content is defined as what is inside or included in something. Something is abstract, right? The material which you provide or give by writing, specifics, no. What else? Get to the chat box fast. Useful information. Information is fine. Material, what kind of material? Is it a cloth? Cloth is also material, right? Expression of information is fine. We shared it, that it is information. Right, get to the chat box fast. Okay, no, so nobody is getting this. So content is any kind of information. It is any kind of knowledge that you share or what you call the expertise, right? It is creativity and it is the experience that you share through your writing. So this is the purpose of the content, the requisite of the content, that why you are writing content. Are you sharing information? Are you sharing any knowledge? Are you sharing any creativity? Are you sharing any experience? Supposedly, if you're sharing an experience, it will be a blog, right? Creativity will be stories, poetry, right? All of that will be content. Knowledge is when you are sharing any kind of academic content, right? The academic guide, study material, that will all be the information when you are sharing or writing articles. So these are the prime forms of writing. But then, yes, there can be many things in sharing information. It can be the user manuals. It can be the technical writing form, the medical journals, and a lot of forms of content there. So the content is information, knowledge, creativity, and experience that you write or use. See, information, experiences, knowledge, and creativity. Now, what are the requisites? What do you need to write content? Let's just understand. What are the requisites of content writing? What do you need to write content? What are the requisites of content writing? Get to the chat box fast. See, bring in some energy. What do you need? You not need knowledge. Okay, fine. But then creativity. Yes, you need some kind of creativity. Language skills. Absolutely right. So you need, so first thing that you need for content writing is not the language skills. What else? We do need the language skills. Grammar is a part of language skills only. We do need the language skills, but not only the language skills. What else you need? First and foremost, you need a purpose. Why you are writing content? Clarity of message conveyed. Yes, that's fine. So first and foremost, we need a purpose. Why you want to write content? So purpose can be any of the above fours. The purpose can be sharing information. The purpose can be sharing knowledge, sharing creativity, or sharing experience. The first thing that you need in content writing is the purpose. Now, second thing, what is that you need to, once you have the purpose, what is the next thing that you decide about content writing? Let's just get to the chat box. Fast, to convey the information clearly, that is fine. That is to communicate, fine. Audience, yes, that who is gonna read this content, right? So when you're writing a parenting blog, who is your target audience? Get to the chat box. When you're writing a parenting blog, parents, when you're writing a fitness article, who is your target audience? You are writing a book review, fitness freaks. Exactly. Why youth? No, that is stereotyping. I am pretty old, but then I'm a fitness freak, right? Children? No, not at all. Fitness enthusiasts, absolutely right. So when you are writing a book review, who is your target audience? Get to the chat box. So the first thing, okay, let's just see what is there in the chat box again. Readers, avid readers who are reading the books. When you are writing a book review, obviously the readers are your target audience. The next thing that you decide for your content is the target audience, that who's going to read this content. And the third thing is you communicate with these target audiences, right? So with these target audiences, you communicate. Now, how do you communicate? Communication can happen in many ways. What is communication at the first place? Get to the chat boxes. What is communication? What is communication? Get to the chat boxes, everyone, please. What do you feel is the communication? Conveying? No, I am conveying something. Is it communication? Exchanging the information? Art of expression? No, not at all. To let others know what you think? No. Transforming information? No. Oh my God. Two-way message? No. I am saying something and you are saying something. Is it communication? Expressing medium of knowledge, not at all. No, to understand, exactly, Pavitra. So communication is that what I intend to say. What is communication? What I intend to say should be conveyed without any ambiguity to the target audience. This is what communication is in content writing. Now let's just see an example. The father and the son knew that he was not happy with the adoption of another boy. Now, can you tell me if this sentence is communicating to you? Get to the chat box. The father and the son knew that he was not happy with the adoption of another boy. Let's just see who is not happy, why it is not communicating. Not very clear. What is not clear? Exactly. Who was not happy? We don't know. So the father, let's just say, make it better. So the father adopted the boy and he was happy. Now tell me, is this sentence communicating with you? Tell me. Get to the chat box fast. Yes. Okay, why? Tell me who was happy. Tell me who was happy. How? It can be the boy. Did I mention that who is happy? The father. Why it is the father only? I can, as a reader, yes, exactly. It is not clear if the father or the son is happy. So what you have to do, the father adopted the boy and the boy was happy, right? Now, is this fine yet? Is this fine yet? Get to the chat box. Yes, now it is clear. Now, what if it is clear? Grammatically, it is right now. So here I will put boy and the boy was happy. I just remove this was and add felt. Better? Yes or no? What's more powerful now? So boy was abstract. This is crystal clear. Exactly. So the father adopted the boy and the boy felt happy because you are describing a feeling here. So instead of using the transition word, transition words are is, are, of, by, these are the transition words. These are called the abstract words. We will learn this in power writing, but these are called the abstract words. So instead of using the abstract words, it's better to use the concrete verbs. Okay. So the next rules, let's just also understand the rules of content writing. So the rules of content writing are that, let's just understand a few rules also of content writing. Just a sec. Are you all able to see the screen? Yes. Okay, fine. Great. So now the rules of content writing are use, replace, abstract, or what you call the transition words with powerful verbs, or what you call is the concrete verbs, like I did here. The boy felt happy. This is one of the rules for content writing and the basic rules to express yourself better. So somebody says that I want to learn how to express myself better. So this is the first rule that you should follow in writing, that you replace the transition words. What are the transition words? Is, are, was, were, by. All of those are transition words that do not add. They only transform or make the sentence or verbs, collect them into a meaningful sentence, right? They play no they add no value to your sentence. So you should try avoiding them and use concrete verbs instead. That is one way of making your content powerful, right? So that is what the third thing is, that you should communicate. How do you communicate with your target audience? To communicate with your target audience, the first thing that you need is the language skills, right? You need the language skills. Let's just understand, what are the language skills? Anybody who can tell me what are the part of the language skills? Get to the chat boxes. Get to the chat boxes and tell me what are the part of the language skills. Spellings, reading, okay, correct grammar, absolutely right. Spellings, correct grammar, organizing the matter, which is called the transition, yes. Right, vocabulary. Okay, let's just start with the language skills only and let's just understand the vocabulary, right? So let's just understand the vocabulary first. Let's just get to the language skills now. So I would ask you a few spellings and you are going to write it in the chat box. Few simple spellings that you use in everyday life. So liaison, get to the chat box now. Wrong. Not even a single person has written it right yet. Okay, get to the chat box and write the spelling of acclimatize. Yes, Ariba has written it. C.R. Chaudhary also wrote it right. But then get to the, I will tell you. Now there is a tool. Okay, I'll discuss the tool with you, but get to the chat box and write the spelling of supersede. common word. Acclimatize. Okay, yes, acclimatize is fine. Supersede, wrong. Supersede, wrong. No. Yes, this is right. Yeah, write the spelling of vacuum. Get to the chat box, everyone. Supersede is wrong. Vacuum. A few have written it wrong. Okay, this is right. This is wrong. Right. Okay, get to the spelling of, get to the chat box and write the spelling of maintenance. Regular words, and a lot of you are writing wrong spellings. Maintenance. All right. Write the spelling of deductible. Get to the chat box, everyone. Okay, a few of you have written it wrong. Only one person has written it right yet. Two people have written it right yet. Rest, everybody has written it wrong. Yeah, write the spelling of embarrass. Get to the chat box. Now, these are the spellings. No, a lot of people have written it wrong. No, these are the spellings that a lot of you are using it in daily life, but you don't know the spelling. Write the spelling of weird. Write the spelling of weird. See. See, I-N-E, placement of I-N-E is wrong. So what I suggest you to do is, how many of you know this tool, dictionary.com? See, let's see the spelling of vacuum. Vacuum is, go to dictionary.com and you can enroll yourself for the vocabulary boost. You will get one word every day. So you can check the spellings. You can download the app also. And our app is also available. This is the spelling of vacuum, right? And what is the spelling of supersede? I asked you for the spelling of supersede. A lot of people wrote it wrong. Supersede. See, this is the spelling of supersede, right? A lot of people wrote it wrong. Then write the spelling of rhythm. Get to the chat box. Write the spelling of rhythm. No, supersede is wrong, Pyle. Supersede is written S-E-D-E, right? Rhythm. Yes, a few of you have written it right, but then a lot of people write it wrong. Okay, so supersede is written this way. Vacuum, I told you, it is V-A-C-W-M. It is never V-A-C-C-U-M, right? That's wrong. Then deductible is written like this. Let me just show you. Deductible is written like this, right? See. Now, let's just understand a few pronunciations. I'm sure many of you pronounce it as cachet. So how do you pronounce? How many of you pronounce it as cachet? Get to the chat boxes fast. Yes or no? Cachet, yes. This is called cash, right? You can also check the pronunciation here on dictionary.com. See, this is pronounced as cash.
Cash.
See, now how do you pronounce this? This is epitome. How many of you pronounce it as epitome? Get to the chat box. No, this is not American and British English. No, supersede. No, this is not American. Supersede. American and British English, it will remain the same spelling. Okay. And epitome. This is, yes, this is not epitome. This is pronounced as epitome. Right? So Adobe. It's not Adobe. It is Adobe. So this is pronounced as epitome. Right? So you can also check the pronunciation. So what you need to do today to become a better writer is go to dictionary.com, download the app now, because it will give you a word of the day so that you use the right spellings, right? So you can go to dictionary.com. Let me just show you dictionary.com, and see, this has a slang dictionary. This also have an emoji dictionary. What is the meaning of any kind of emoji and any emoji? And what is it? Also has a gender and sexuality dictionary. The new words that have come into practice, like patriarchy and all of that. Okay, so you can put your name here and you can get a word of the day every day on dictionary.com. Right, that is one way of doing it, learning or boosting your vocabulary. Okay, that is one way of boosting your vocabulary, because indeed vocabulary is important, but you don't have to become Shashi Tharoor. Because writing two difficult words, or if your reader has to dive into the dictionary every now and then while reading your content, they will feel bored and leave it. You will not be able to communicate with the reader in that sense. Okay, so this is the first rule of language skills that you have to do with vocabulary, right? The first thing that you do to communicate is you build a vocabulary which is crystal clear. Instead of using any kind of abstract or transition words, you use concrete and powerful. Use simple words. You don't have to become a you know, like I said, that you don't have to write like Shashi Tharoor, because that is a niche audience. But when it comes to content, the purpose is to communicate with your reader in simple, crisp, clear, catchy sentences. How to write? Now, the first thing is vocabulary that we discuss in content writing. The next thing would be what? Get to the chat boxes. Misunderstood or misspelt words. Misspelt words. Now I am just writing this. The black shoes. Smoky. See, the black shoes complemented her smoky look. Now write the spelling of complimented in the chat box. Wrong. Okay. Complimented is fine. No, everybody has written it wrong. Okay. Narmada Rao wrote it right. Why it would be complimented? So there are two types of compliment. This is complimented her smoking look. This has come from complete. Right? So I meant to say that by the black shoes, completed her smoky look. So when you have to say that it has to be completed her smoky look, then it will be complimented. It will be pronounced like or spelled like this. And let's just understand the difference. The black shoes complimented her smoky look, and she received many compliments for her what? Suggest a word now. Suggest a word for her. Fill in the blanks. The black shoes complimented her smoking look, and she received many compliments for her shoes. No. Attire. No. You are talking about the look. So why would it, you know, outlook? No. Your dress doesn't allow you to get up. No. Not at all. So you have to be concrete here. I said outfit. No. It's only the outfit. It's about the entire look. Right? Wearings, no, you have to get complete. So for her beauty or for her grace, full, graceful, yeah, for her appearance, graceful appearance, right? So you have to be concrete. You can't be writing, yeah, attire or graceful attire or beauty. So all of that, you have to be concrete. Now coming on to what is the difference between pen, paper, pencil? How do you spell stationery there? Get to the chat box. How do you spell stationery there? Right. Stationery. No, wrong. The stationery is spelled like this. Stationery. This means pen, paper, and pencil. This would mean this anything which is stationed, you know, which is not moving. So that would be stationery. This would mean, stationary would mean anything which is stationed and not moving. So get to this. So obviously, dictionary.com is definitely going to help you with the word or the vocabulary building. However, I do not recommend to write too difficult words into your writing, because it will put off your reader. Your reader writes simple. The next rule in content writing, that replace transition words with concrete words, write simple, crisp, clear and catchy sentences. Okay, should I put a comma before and or not? Yeah, write simple. No, why not? Yes, why? Yes, Megha is saying yes. So this is a list of things that I am writing in a sentence, that write simple, crisp, clear and catchy sentences. So there is a list of things. So when you put a comma, this is called the Oxford comma in writing. Okay, this is called the Oxford comma in writing, and you can use this comma while using a list. When you create a list in a sentence, or a listicle is a sentence, you should use a comma. This is called the Oxford comma that has come from Oxford Press, right? If you are, especially if you're writing British English and American English, you will use this comma. Now, coming on to the language skills, which is the vocabulary, the misspelt words, and how to write. What are the, how to write crisp, clear, catchy sentences. Let's just say, as per my opinion, this wasteful policy is ought to be revoked. How many words? Tell me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How do you make it crisp, clear, and catchy? Can you suggest another way to write this to make it better? Is should not come. Okay, as per my opinion, this wastewater policy is ought to be revoked. No, it should be there. Comma after opinion. Okay, fine. What else? No, but then I am talking about the sentences. How to write crisp, clear, catchy sentences. So I'm just trying to understand. If you have to make this sentence, how will you make it? Should be revoked. This, as per my opinion, this wasteful policy is pay policy should be revoked. Okay, you can make it comma after opinion is fine. But then, yeah. All right, let's just say I add the comma also. Remove is. All right, revoke this wasteful policy. Right, I just... Yes, exactly. So Payal has written it right. I suggest to revoke this wasteful policy. What is more powerful now? What is more powerful? What is more powerful? I suggest revoke this wasteful policy. Less words. So yeah, so it is less words and it is always more power. What you have to do is write it tight. Remove, how do you write it tight? The next rule of writing, the remove redundant phrases. Redundant phrases. What are redundant phrases? Tell me. I got a free gift from her. What is redundant in it? I received a free gift. Free gift is always for free. It was an added perk to my salary. What is redundant? Added. Okay. Now, let's just say that he was an armed gunman. Armed is redundant, so you should not write all of that. So he kneeled down to propose to her. Right. Well, he kneeled down to propose to her. Kneeled, exactly. Do you kneel in upward direction? So kneeled. Yeah. So yes, he kneeled to propose to her. Please mix all the ingredients together. Do you mix separately also? Together is redundant. Yes, exactly. Please mix all the ingredients. So do not just now cut those words which are not adding any value to your sentences. Now I want you to write, you know, why content writing? Let's just say how to add power in simple sentences. Why content writing is important in today's world. In today's world. I want you to write 5 sentences about it. Just get to the chat box, everyone. Let's just become a content writer now. Get to the chat box, everyone. Just write any 5 sentences about it. Why content writing is important in today's world. I'll allow you 2 minutes because it should not take more than 2 minutes for anyone to write this. You don't have to make it grammatically perfect, but then yes, I mean, the idea should be there. No. Just write sentences. We will just add some power to this sentence. Atul? Why content writing is important in today's world. There is more scope to it. See, this is an assignment, writing assignment that I have given it to you. No, I'm not asking the answers. All right, okay, you have not understood. So just write 5 sentences on this topic. Write 5 sentences on this topic. Everybody, can you get to the chat box? Let me just pick up what you have written. To make an impact on the reader. Somebody said that there is more scope to it. There's more scope to it. And then I will use some. It is the global era. Digital marketing. It means earning from home. It is a means of earning from home. See, somebody, Payal has already written, content writing is a platform to share information. Digital platforms are expanding, wherein content writing is at the base of it. More than yesterday, it is a need of today. Let's just say, how these are simple sentences. Let's just see how you can add power into these sentences. Let me just get to this. So I'll just copy it here, and then we will change these sentences and we will learn more about this. Okay, so content writing is a platform to share information. All right, is it a platform to share information? So content writing is a platform. Is content is written, let's just make it short, crisp, clear, and catchy, is written to share information, right? Digital platforms are expanding, wherein content writing is at the base of it, okay? Writing or content is to share information, and content is the prime requisite for any digital platform. What is better now? Tell me who, I don't remember whose content was it, right? And content is the prime requisite for any digital platform, right? Wherein content writing is the base of it. More than yesterday, it is needed today, right? More than yesterday, it is a need today. So do you need this sentence now when you have added the word requisite? Right? Do you need this sentence? You wrote three sentences and I just wrote two. I just added a word and the content is better. Right? So this is what you have to keep in mind while writing content, that you have to write it tight. You know, use more powerful words, use more powerful phrases. Try to cut your sentences short. Writing long sentences doesn't make sense. What you have to do is write the right sentences which are delivering your message absolutely right. Okay. So this is what you call power writing. You have to add power to simple sentences. Now, coming back to the language skills that we are going to learn is the punctuation. So punctuation, the first thing is obviously the period, which is full stop. You end the sentence with it. I will take up three or four important punctuations. One is the comma. Where do you put a comma? Between two independent clauses. What are two independent clauses? So there is a simple sentence. Let's just understand what is a simple sentence. I love my daughter. It is one simple sentence. Will have one verb, one clause, and one subject. I is the subject, clause is what I do, and love is the verb. Full stop. She loves me too. A separate clause. What she does. Separate subject. So you just add this with a coordinating conjunction and put a comma. Since these are two independent clauses, you will put a comma before the conjunction. This is called the between two independent clauses in a complex sentence. So this was a simple sentence when there was a full stop here, and now this has become a compound sentence. Right? So writing sentences is indeed important. Why? Tell me. How do you write sentences? Should you write all the sentences of the same length? Okay, let me just tell you. I'll write something for you and then tell me what makes sense to you. The sentence should have five words. Five. Okay, let's just see. Here are five more words, full stop. Five word sentences are fine, full stop. Several together become monotonous, full stop. Is this, when you're reading this, tell me, is this engaging you? Is it looking, you know, listen to what is happening. Do you find it engaging, catchy? Right? Do you find? No. Why? Because this is what we call flat writing. This is called flat writing. Your sentences are falling flat. So what you need to do? What you need to do here? Five is repeated many times. Okay, fine. This is called flat writing. So here, so every word has only five to six, every sentence has only five to six sentences. There is no variation in complex sentence, compound sentence, and a simple sentence. I'm sure you know that what is a powerful word is needed. Powerful words, this is called flat writing. Now, how do you make it powerful? This was the flat writing. How do you make it powerful? Now, listen, right? I vary the sentence length to bring in or to bring engagement or to make my content clear and catchy. You should do the same too, because it is the content or it is the language that helps engage a reader, right? Or it is the writing style. Now, what is this? Engage a reader. Now, do you find it better? Powerful? Yes or no? Yes or no? Of course, this is called a powerful writing. So never write flat sentences. Always vary the length of your sentences. Write simple sentence, write. There are three types of sentences. Primarily, there are four types of sentences. There is simple sentence, there is compound sentence, there is a complex sentence, and then there is complex compound sentence. Right? We never write complex compound sentence in content writing by rule, because this is considered as wordy content. Okay, so we never write anything like this. So never write a complex compound sentence, but you can make a mix of simple sentence, compound sentence, and complex sentence. So you will put a comma between two independent clauses. You will put a comma after introductory phrase, which is, you know, hi or however, right? And then you will put a comma to give a pause to the reader. Okay, so this is how you use a reader in a sentence, right? So this is how you use the comma. Coming on to quotation marks, what is this called? The I love my daughter and she loves me too. So where, first and foremost, this is called the quotation marks, right? This is not called, and this is called the quote. Right, there is a difference between the quote and the quotation marks. The punctuation that you use to write the verbatim said by someone is the quote. Is the quotation mark, and the exact words that you use to or the direct speech is called the quote. Okay, so there is a difference. These are here. You will use double inverted commas because you are presenting a quote. But when you want to emphasize on something, so I recommend contribution. So when you want to highlight something, contribution and not intervention, you will use single inverted commas. You will not use double inverted commas. That is the difference. So a lot of people use, you know, just the double inverted commas to, yeah, you can, yeah. So a lot of people use the double inverted commas to bring in the emphasis. No, it's absolutely wrong. You should not be doing it. Okay, clear? How to write? Yeah, so this is the next rule. Now, coming on to misunderstood phrases, you also write some kind of misunderstood phrases. What are the misunderstood phrases? Get to the chat box and write first come, first serve. How do you write it? Get to the chat box fast. Write the first come, first serve. Then we will do British and American English also. Come first, no, first come, first serve is wrong. Everybody is writing it wrong. Get to the chat box fast. No, first come, first served is the right phrase. Why? Because this means the one who comes first will serve. This would mean the one who comes first will serve. Right? So it has to be first come and first served will be served, which is the right phrase. Okay? Get to the chat box and write USP, the full form of USP, unique selling proposition. Get to the chat box fast. unique selling proposition. Wrong. Wrong. It's not unique selling proposition. Unique selling proposition is wrong. USP is wrong. No, I asked for the full form of unique selling proposition. Unique selling proposition is written like this. Unique selling proposition, which means this has come from propose. What is so unique that you are selling to you, that you are proposing to sell? This is written like this. Everybody has written it wrong. This is called unique selling proposition. What is that you have to, you know, what is that you propose to sell that is unique into your content? Okay, so that is how. Now that next rule is the misunderstood phrases. So this this would need then you come with the fluff words. Let's say she is a very good trainer. She is an excellent trainer. What is more powerful now? The first one or the second one? Obviously the second one. So never fluff words are very, rarely, suddenly. All of these are fluff words. Actually, just don't use them. You know, for every very, very happy is delighted. Very noisy is deafening. Very often is frequently. So there is always a word for every very, right? So don't use very in your content. It is not required. Very quiet is silenced. All right, or mute, okay? Very shy is timid. Very simple is basic. So there is always one word. Very good is excellent. So don't use very in your content. Very rarely, suddenly, actually, these are not required. So these are the language skills that you need to understand while writing, okay? So all of these are important. Now coming on to the next part of your content, I will take another rules of content writing, that how do you communicate with the reader? You need the language skills to communicate, plus you need the readability. So how do you make your content readable? With grammar check. So there is a tool called Grammarly. So you can go here, check your content. Like I have checked a lot of content here, right? So you can go here and check your content on Grammarly, okay? So it will also show you a lot of scores or goals that you can suggest that in writing. Okay, so this will always show you some kind of information on where you can correct your content, and you can go to Grammarly and check. However, you cannot depend on Grammarly completely. There are other rules of grammar that doesn't check. Okay, that Grammarly doesn't check. So there are many things that the Grammarly won't fix. It will fix the basic punctuations. It will fix the basic grammar for you. But then yes, writing needs a lot beyond Grammarly. So you can go to Grammarly and check your content grammatically if you want to. The basics will be checked here. But then yes, you cannot rely on Grammarly completely. You need to learn the basics or the grammatical skills to learn content writing. Now coming on to the next thing, the readability. Next thing is the searchability. So as I said, that the digital world is ruled by searchability, ruled by content. So anything that you go or you need, you go to Google, like you do content writing course online. What is coming up? Content. Okay. So are you able to see? Okay, let's just say, you know, let's just find Kangana Ranaut blog. Let's just do this, you know? Okay, by the way, this blog is written by me. Coming on top even before Times of India. Even before Times of India, right? So this is search engine. This is called search engine optimization. Out of 17,20,000 results in 50 seconds, my blog is ranking on top. This is called search engine optimization. Right, this is called a keyword. This is a short tail keyword. Now a short tail keyword is the one which is just two or three words, but it will not give you the specific details of anything. It will give you more, it will give you diversified results and not the specific results. Like I give you an example, content writing will not give you, or let's just say a short tail keyword, numerology, astrology and vastu is something that will not give you. Supposedly you are, you know, how does it change the destiny? Supposedly you are trying to find that how does it change the destiny? You just get the diversified results and not exactly the results that you are trying to find. So what you have to do is that you have to use a long tail keyword, which is, you know, for, let's just say how numerology, astrology and vastu change the destiny. This is called a long tail keyword. Let's just see, this is again my blog ranking on top. So you have to target the keywords to for search engine optimization. How do you target the keywords? You can go to keywords everywhere and add a Chrome extension like this, like I have added. You can just go and install for Chrome. It's easy. There is a video there how to install it for Chrome, and it will suggest the keywords to you as much as you want to. Now coming on the next thing, which is there is something called answerthepublic.com. So it is a search engine, or it is the information that you can find for long tail keywords, that what people are searching on internet. So you can go to content writing and actually let's just say select your country, India. I'll just tell you about, let's see, GHI India, and just search. You will find what people are searching on Google. Okay. And there is another tool called also asked.com. So there are a few other tools like Uber Suggest. There is something called Google Keyword Planner tool. There is KW Finder. These all are the tools. SEMrush. These are the tools to find the keywords. And once see, this is what people are searching on Google about content writing. Okay, so you can also find the keywords here and blend them into your content to write SEO content. Okay, fine. So anybody has any questions? So you have to make your content readable, searchable, and you have to have an inviting or catchy title. This is the last topic that I'm covering today. So how to write what is the first thing that grabs your attention while you are reading anything? While you're reading something, what is the first thing, or what is the last thing that grabs your attention? Topic, the headline, how to write a catchy headline. Okay, supposedly you are writing an article about content writing. Get to the chat box and write what will be the title that you will choose. And how do you know if it is a catchy title? Get to the chat box. This is the last thing that I'm doing here. What will be the, supposedly you are writing an article about content writing, or supposedly you are writing an article about living in a new world. Does it show that you are writing about content writing, Tux? No. So what I recommend you to do is write a headline analyzer. Use a headline analyzer. Headline analyzer is from CoSchedule. This one is the best. Beauty of writing. Earn massive income with content writing. Let's just see. Earn massive. Earn massive income with content writing. All right, let's just see how does it work for you. Let's just analyze the score. Any score which beyond 70 should be fine. Earn massive income with content writing. Now let's just see what is the score of this headline. 45, which is not that great. Now how to earn, let's just make how to earn. Let's just write it here. Okay, this is coming in between, so I have to move it somewhere. How to earn an awesome income with simple content writing. I just added two words into your chat, into your headline. And now let's just see the score, right? Let's just see the score. I just added two words into your, two, three words into your headline, 79. See, this is a, so how to earn. Here you are giving a WIIFM factor, which means what is in it for me. The reader knows that there is something for me that I already do not know. Okay, so how to earn an awesome income with simple content writing. So try to add some kind of power words. So this is how you write a catchy headline. You have to tell your reader that there is something awesome in it, and there is something simple in it. Okay, this is how you work with headlines. So headline is the only way to attract your readers. It takes only 2 to 3 seconds for the reader to engage with your content, right? So you only spend 2 to 3 minutes, 2 to 3 seconds on a headline and you scroll further. So ideally you have only 2 to 3 seconds of the reader on the internet. And the average reading span of reader is only 3 to 5 minutes on internet. So your headline has to be super inviting. Unless it is super inviting, your content will not be read and it will go unnoticed on internet. Okay. So this is what we are going to do here. And this is how you write a catchy headline. So now coming on to the next, this was the last thing that I have covered. Now coming back to the presentation, we have understood what content writing is. We need a purpose. We need it readable. We need inviting and catchy title. We need all of that, right? Now coming on to, now we are nearing the end of the course. So what you need to do in content marketing, that you have to define your niche, that what exactly you want to write about. You can build your personal brand. Personal brand is something like that. If you go to Google and say content writing courses in India, you will find Henry Harvin on top. If you write Vandana Saxena, blogger, writer, trainer, you will find me on top. So that is called the branding. You know, you have to build a brand in the digital world. Otherwise, you will get lost in the digital world. It is huge. You have to write it right and earn well. Choose a marketing channel. Do you want to choose social media? Do you want to choose newsletter marketing? What do you want to use? Topical is something that, you know, which is like the farmers are trending these days, the trending content. The strategic content is that you plan your content for the month in advance and create content which is specific to your niche or to your interest. That is called a content strategy. All right. So this is what I could cover in 1 hour. I hope I was able to help you. But before we wrap up the course, I will just tell you about the upcoming batches, which is the weekend batch starting from 14th March, that is tomorrow. And I will be taking this batch personally, right? So if you want to enroll for this, I will be taking this batch, right? And the next batch starts on 15th March. If you want to talk to someone, please call 901-526-2666. There is a link in the chat box that you must see. There is a link in the chat box. So if you want to get the PPT of the webinar, you can fill the form in the given link and you will get the PPT also. Okay, right? So all of that is here. And if you want to enroll for the content writing course, I will take up the question. Let me just see. So I will take up the questions. But then to get the PPT of the course, you can just fill in the form. I'm just posting the link again in the chat box. You can just fill in the form and you will get the PPT of the presentation there. For more information on any of the content writing, on this content writing course, you should call 901-526-2666. Now, I also have a news to break, right? So if you call now, because April onwards, there will be a revision. There will be a revision in the fee structure for content writing, right? Just because the financial year is changing. So you have to enroll it if you want to add or get some additional discount, or you have to get at a good price. Just, you know, call up now and register for the course tomorrow. This is what the training was all about. And I have told you that what all we will cover in the training, we will all cover the content niches, which is creative writing, article blog writing, technical writing, academic writing, medical writing, copywriting, SEO writing, branding, content, and a lot more, right? How much SEO is taught? Every aspect of SEO is taught, Kamlesh. And how to get perfect synonyms of the specific words? Just Google it. It's a simple synonym of this. You will find it. Or otherwise, there is a tool called wordhippo.com. I'm just posting it here, wordhippo.com. In next 5 minutes, I will take any questions if you have, but then yes, I'll try to cover as much as I can. How to get perfect synonyms, I've answered. All right. How do you write? Okay, this was the yes. Okay, what else? All right. Okay, right. I've taken all the questions until here. So anybody has any questions, I'm here for 5 minutes to take up the questions. Will you also cover creative writing? How different? Yes, creative writing is... content writing is completely the writer, reader's perspective, because you think about the target audience first and then you write your content. Creative writing is always the writer's perspective. You don't think about your target audience. So creative writing, content writing is to communicate, and creative writing is to create visuals in the reader's mind. So that is, there is a lot of description. The creative writing is based on descriptive and narrative writing style, whereas there are four types of writing styles, expository, persuasive, writing style, there will be descriptive writing style and narrative writing style. In content writing, we might use four of them. But in creative writing, it is based on descriptive and narrative writing style, right? So please fill the form to get the PPT of the webinar. How long is the duration of each day's course? I will not be able to answer any questions on that. So you have to call up the number that I suggested here. So this is the number 9015266266. How we should start writing, and I mean where to start, just get down, bend on your laptop and write the first word. The next will follow automatically, right? It is as easy and as hard it is. All right. What else? Any more questions? I'm here for another 2 minutes. I can answer any more questions if you have. Will this be ideal for me as I want to improve my business writing skills? Indeed. Why not? Writing skills are writing skills. Yes. Will you be available in batches after March? Yes, I will be available. I'm working with Henry Hubbin for more than 1 year now. But then, yes, there will be a revision in the fee. So I would not want you to pay extra for this, for the course. So it's better to register now because there is a batch starting tomorrow and I'll be taking the batch. How much you charge for the course? I don't charge for the course. It's you. I can't give you anything, any information on that. I'm sorry, but that's, will creative writing covered in content writing? Yes. Creative writing is covered in content writing. However, Henry Hubbin also has a detailed creative writing course about how to write a best-selling novel, right? Okay. What else? I can take 2-3 more questions. Otherwise, I will wrap up. So I would still recommend you to... Yes, Rajni, it will be covered. We will cover creative writing as well. Job opportunities, there Henry Hubbin also offers an internship program for the fresh content writers, and also there are a lot of jobs since content is the booming industry these days. And let me tell you that from the month of April, the recruitment takes off. So obviously there are a lot of opportunities for the jobs in content writing, because this is the booming industry. This is the king now. I mean, it's the next big thing these days. How to know the fee? Call up 9015266266. Are writing assignments part of the course? Indeed. Without writing assignments, you cannot become a writer. Will it be exclusively online? Yes, it will be exclusively online. To writing and a research article has to explain the interpretation which was published, how to rewrite the content of published. That I can't teach you in like 2 minutes, but then to rewrite, you need to spin the content again and make it add some power. Yes, Samuel, you can definitely. Can I make it? The question should be, do you want to make it as a career or not? If you want to, you can do anything. The question, never ask yourself, can I do this? Ask yourself whether I want to do this. If you want to do this, you can do anything. Get the PPT of the webinar. There is a link, just fill in the form, right? So this is what we have today. Let me just, if there are no further questions, I'll just close the chat box and I'll just close the, wrap up the class also. I hope all of you enjoyed the course, enjoyed the class. If yes, please say yeah. So if yes, please say thanks. Say yes in the chat box. I was reading thanks actually. All right. I hope all of you enjoyed the class. So say thanks. Say yes in the chat box. Again, I'm saying yes because I'm reading thanks. I'm reading the chat box while say yes in the chat box. Okay. Thank you everyone for joining in. It was wonderful too. Thank you, everyone. And it was wonderful to interact with all of you. So I look forward to see you all in the content writing course. Have a great Sunday ahead. Thank you. So I'm wrapping it up here.